Hello, madam. Today we can start with the
Java exception. Yesterday we have completed what is the error, how many types of errors we have. Error is a mistake. In whenever we are going to be start writing any programming language, we are going to be getting the errors. How many types of errors we have? Two types. First one is the compile time errors. Second one will be runtime errors. Compile time errors will be, we need to call it as a all syntax errors, we need to call it as a compile time errors. Today we can start with once again recall the previous section and we can start with the exceptions. An exception or exceptional event is a problem that arises during the execution of the problem. Means when we are going to be getting the exception event is a problem. This problem will be arises during the execution of a program. Whenever we are going to be compiling or executing the program, at that time we are going to be exception will be raised. When exception occurs, normal flow of the program will be disturbed and the program and application. When exception is raised, the normal execution of the flow of the execution will be interrupted or it will be stop the execution. Which is not recommended. Therefore, these exceptions are to be handled. An exception can occur in different reasons. Means many reasons we have, we get the exception. Below given are some scenarios where an exception occurs. Below some statements will be given when exception is raised. First one is the user can enter invalid data. Suppose user can enter the invalid data. At that time, we are going to be getting the exception. A file that needs to be opened cannot be found. Means, whatever file we are going to be opening, that file could not be opened. At that time, we are going to be getting the exception. A network connection has been lost in the middle of the communication. Suppose we are going to be communicating one system to another system or JVM. We are going to be running on the files. At that time, communication will be lost. That is, at that time also we are going to be getting the exception. Some of these exceptions are caused by the user error. Means these exceptions will be raised when the user will be do the mistakes. Other by the programmer error, other by the physical resources have been failed some manner. Means when we are going to be getting the exceptions, user can enter the invalid data or system will be interrupted or failed some application, at that time we are going to be getting the exception. Based on these have categories of the exception. Based on these exception reasons, they are going to be classified into the, we are going to be handling the exceptions. How many we can handle the exceptions in how many ways? Two ways. First one is the checked exceptions. Second one will be checked exceptions. Second one will be unchecked exceptions. First we can start with the, based on these we have a three categories of exceptions. First one by one we can see. Based on these we have a three categories of exceptions. You need to understand them to know how exception handling works in Java. Means how to handle the exceptions. Means without stopping the normal flow of the execution, we need to continue the remaining program. That is, that will be handled by the exceptions. What is the exception? Exception is a condition by using that whenever program interruption is done, at that time normal flow of the execution without interruption, remaining statements will be executed. That is the use of the exceptions. First category of the exception will be checked exception. Checked exception is the exception that occurs at the compile time. Means this exception will be occurs at what time? Compile time. Means this exception will be raised at what time? Compile time. Means this type of errors will be done by whom? User. These are also called compile time exceptions. These exceptions cannot be simply be ignored. At the time of the compilation, the programmer should take care of to handle these exceptions. Means programmer must and should be can handle these type of exceptions, because of we can system cannot handle these type of exceptions. First whenever we are going to be getting the compile time exceptions, first we can read each and every line and we can rectify the errors. Again, once again we need to compile the program. That is the use of the checked exceptions. For example, if you use the file reader class in your program, read the data from a file. Means here we are going to be using the class file. Which class file? File reader class. In the file, specify the constructor does not exist. File not found, exception will be occurred. Means whenever we are going to be reading the file, class file reader will be read by the compiler. At that time, we are not going to be found any constructor. At that time, we are going to be getting the which type of exception? File not found exception. And compiler prompt, the programmer can handle the exception. This is about the checked exceptions. In the below example, here we are going to be using the two packages. First one is the import java.io file. Next, import java.io file reader package. These are the two class files we are going to be using. This class file will be imported by using which package? java.io package. Then we have created one class, public class file not found demo. Then in that we are going to be creating a one main method. Then we are going to be creating a one object. Which file? Here we are going to be giving some file name. Which file name? This file will be existing on where? In the file reader. At that time, this file will be read by the compiler. The constructor is not available on where? In the file reader. This type of error will be, we need to call it as a compile time exception. If you try this example above program, we'll get the exception as shown below. Means below we have given the exception. See here. See in the output it should be displayed Java C file not found demo.java. We are going to be compiling. Then file not found Java error. An error and reported exception, file not found exception must be catched or declared to be thrown. Means here we are going to be getting the exception. We need to handle that exception and we need to write the reasons for the exception also, and we need to catch that exception and we need to throw that exception also. This is the error message will be displayed on where? On the